Eagles and Jags both sitting at 3-4, and here's why that's important for tomorrow's game. So since 1990, 4-4 teams have a 31.6 chance of making the postseason. But whoever loses tomorrow, they're going to fall to 3-5, which statistically drops their playoff probability down to just 8%. I mean, obviously, you need to just win these games right now. So, Kay, both these teams are in complete desperation mode tomorrow.
I like it. They're going to gut it out in front of a packed audience full of fans. We're going to cheer every time playoff any game. Touchdown is scored. I'm loving it. Thanks so much, Colleen, for highlighting that. So, Steve, let's start with you here. Yes. Which of these teams, the Eagles or the Jags, do you think has a better chance of getting back to the playoffs?
For me, it's really easy. It's because when you look at both teams and what they're doing, you got to go with the Eagles. And I'm going with the Eagles because their quarterback is reliable. Their CEO, their CFO of their team is very reliable. You can count on him. You can see as he's getting the dust off, he's becoming better and better. This team is becoming more efficient. When you look at the Jags, their quarterback issue got benched. Hey, I can say you can give me all the lip service, the PC answers, all you want. But when your quarterback is being benched, it's never good. It is like going on a family trip. Mom and dad aren't allowed to drive, and you're going to give the kids with permits or non-driving permits, opportunity to drive the vehicle. That's never good. You can tell me whatever you want to. I am not buying that bridge in London that's already here that is up for sale. I'm sorry. It's not happening.
You're not going to invest?
I'm not going to invest. I think it's sold.
It is what it is. Live television.
I'm just going with the better football team, the Philadelphia Eagles, right now. They're playing better in all phases, offense, defense. Even in their losses, their biggest loss was 6 points or fewer. So for me, the Philadelphia Eagles are easily the better football team. And to your point, the quarterback position is the most important position, especially for these two teams. And the Jags have too many issues on their side of the ball.
I look at the schedules. That's the way I look at it.
Got to do it. Right. Talk about it.
The Eagles, they have a brutal, brutal schedule this season, guys. They still have to go to L.A. to face the Rams. They've got to take a trip to the Superdome.
Preach, Kay.
It's a gauntlet. But then if you look at the Jags, I feel like if they can right the ship this weekend, Blake Bortles can improve to 4-0. The schedule's pretty flavorable. They play the Colts twice. They get the Bills. They get the struggling Dolphins. I kind of like what the Jags
They got to play Tennessee.
They get to
that
play
was a
Tennessee.
Whole whopping 15 points.
We love the 2017 Jags, right? Like, that team was awesome. I think the thing that's missing, if you take that whole season from last year and put it in one play, one postcard, it's this play right here. It's Leonard Fournette summoning the safeties to say, let's go do this. There was an attitude here. There was a blunt force that they ran with. And I think there's your answer why Blake Bortles isn't as good as he used to be, because he doesn't have 27. Steve, as someone who was in some of those physical confrontations, what do you think of that play?
I love that.
I mean, I love that play. That. You know, you tell them, hey, you're a young kid. You tell them, hey, let's bring it on. But also, too, that guy, you know, that guy that was going against, I think he's unemployed. Just maybe got a job, you know.
Doing what?
I'm not sure what he was doing.
You talking about Mike Mitchell?
Yeah, there's some, the individual.
Sure.
But there's some yard work there in Charlotte on my estate that he can get to if he ever needs some supplemental income. I can take care of it.
They need some supplemental offense with Jacksonville. They need some supplemental offense. I think they missed Leonard Fournette a lot. Carlos Hyde might help, but Leonard Fournette's special. I think they missed some big time.
I think, though, with Leonard Fournette, they actually become a better team when him not in there because they seem to get lazy sometimes. They just hand it off to Leonard Fournette, hand it off to Leonard Fournette.
They're not winning now, though,
but the problem is when it's almost like when you have to pass the ball, if you haven't practiced it, then all of a sudden you're doing something foreign. So, you know, you're like, it's like, what do we do? We got to drop back, pass the ball. You know, so not making excuses, but some of the wide receivers aren't playing up to par that we're expected to.
Fournette's a crutch.
I believe
he is. And now he's on crutches. You know what I mean? That's tough. I think they miss him.
Offensive line,
they
too.
They traded for Carlos Hyde. We'll see what he can do in his debut. I mean, the Eagles do have the number two run defense.
Look out. Let your cars.
I think one thing we can all agree on is that we're so excited to be here.
Talk about
it. And that we have this game tomorrow, less than 24 hours away from kickoff between Philly and Jacksonville. Get your Sunday started with us on NFL Game Day kickoff beginning at 7 a.m. Eastern. You can kick off at 9:30 a.m. Eastern at Wembley. We have all the post-game coverage for you. Everything you need right here on NFL Network. Colleen, let's send it back to you guys in studio. Where, by the way, you need a double-decker bus to get around that studio.
Yeah,
I know. You could do a tour.
It's amazing.
You could tour that thing.
By the way,
it's awesome.
The sky is just so dark.
Yeah, you guys okay
you guys.
Over there?
Is everything going to be all right?
It's very London.
It's going to be great.
It is very London.
You know why? Because I'm here with my wife. That's snuggling weather.
It is snuggling weather. Have you been on the eye yet? The snuggling eye up there, too. You can do it up on the Ferris wheel.
That's awesome. All right. So we asked this question on Twitter.
Thank you, guys. Thank you for that image, Dave.
More likely to make it back to the playoffs this season, the Eagles or the Jaguars? And we threw in both or neither. And, I mean, the neither one right now is in second place with 35%. But 48% of you saying the Eagles.
So your teams.
Both. Not going to happen, probably.